A calmer day at Carson Beach, the story at 11.
Tonight, CBS presents not only with pleasure, but with the greatest of pride, the first of four programs selected from the work of one of America's greatest and best-loved comedians.
From Hollywood, the Jack Benny Program. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we bring you the star of our show, Jack Benny, and here he comes.
Isn't that the most ridiculous entrance that you have ever seen in your life? You know, the reason we did... Oh, fella, wait, just pardon me. So, fellas, hey, get this thing off of here, will you, please? Spooky, isn't it? You know, the reason we do things like that is because... Well, I can't tell you what a comedian has to go through to try and get that first laugh on television. And it's so important, too.
Mr. Benny.
I would like to...
Telephone call for you.
I'm just starting the show now. Hello?
Hello? Is this Jack Benny?
Yes, yes.
The Jack Benny who lives at 366 North Camden Drive and appears on television?
Yes, I'm doing my show right now.
Well, we appreciate that, Mr. Benny. But will you be going home immediately after the show?
Well, of course I'll be going. Who is this, anyway?
This is the United States Treasury Department.
Who is it?
The United States Treasury Department. There's a little matter we'd like to talk to you about.
Talk to me? But look, I... But
we'll see you at your house in about an hour.
But, mister... You hung up? That's strange, the Treasury Department. Maybe they're coming to, I don't know, examine my income tax returns or something. I don't know, that's the first time that's ever happened to me. Well, I'm not going to worry about it now. I've got a show to do, so have with it. Oh, Don! Don! Yeah, I can't understand what those income tax men would want from the...
Yes, Jack, yes?
What is it? What do you want, Don?
You called me.
Yes, that's right, I did. I did call you.
Look, Jack, what's the trouble? What's bothering you?
Nothing is bothering
you. Right, all right, Jack, you don't have to tell me, but if something is upsetting you, why don't you go home?
Go home? How can I go home? We've only been on a few minutes. You know, it's a half-hour show. I still have to do 20 years. I mean, 20. Anyway, I don't know, Don. Maybe I ought to go home, huh? You mind if I go home? Could you take on all right. The rest of the show, will you?
All right, Jack.
Huh?
Okay. Run along.
The Jack Benny Show. Sponsored by Tide. Day in and day out, the dirt you see the most is the dirt Tide cleans the best.
Not too long ago, we lived in the city. Now we have 6 acres in the country.
And things sure have changed.
Meet Jean Tennant. A move to the country changed her life. Her laundry, too. Tide asked her to tell you about it.
With this much land, seems like we're always outside. and we really get dirtier than ever. Before, I did just a few loads a week. The dirt I saw most often wasn't any trouble. Now my wash is almost doubled. I'm always washing jeans and shirts that are absolutely filthy right through to the inside. Well, I found that's the kind of dirt Tide cleans best. See, the jeans are clean, and so is the shirt, even where the dirt was ground through. The way we live now, it's good to know that I can depend on Tide.
Get Tide, because the dirt you see the most is the dirt Tide cleans the best.
We get dirtier, but we've never been happier.
The show was over.
What's the matter?
Well, if you must know, I got a call from the Treasury Department.
Treasury Department?
Yeah, you know, they have charge of income taxes and everything.
Income tax? What's that?
Well, Rochester, that's a tax that people have to pay if they earn over $600 a year, you know.
Oh!
Be glad that you're not involved in it. Anyway, Rochester, believe me, when you get in trouble with the Internal Revenue Department, you can be pretty serious. Yeah, I don't know, they can fine you or put you in prison.
I don't blame for being worried.
Who's worried? I'm just a little upset, that's all.
Boss, why don't you let me fix you a little scotch and soda?
No, I don't want any Alcatraz. I mean, alcohol. No, just leave me alone, will you?
Well, okay.
Gee, I can't figure this thing out. Can't understand it. I mean, I never had anything like this happen. Boy, can they be tough, too. Boy, that's the way they got Al Capone. Gee, maybe they're coming. I don't know. Oh, for heaven's sake, look at all of these ants crawling around the window here. Thousands of ants. I'll fix them. Oh, Rochester!
Yes, boss?
Have we any poison in the house?
Poison? No!
Rochester, that poison wasn't for me. I wasn't going to take it. It was for the ants.
Oh!
I wasn't even thinking about those tax men. Income. I mean... Rochester, look, they're here. I'll tell you what you do. Why don't you go into the kitchen and fix a nice big tray of food and fruit and everything and bring it out here, Peter? Maybe they'll give me a break or something, will you? Go ahead and do that. Oh, come in. Come in, Mr. Gentleman.
Mr. Benny?
Yeah, I'll call him, yeah. No, yes. I am. I'm Jack Benny, sir.
I'm Ned Miller of the United States Treasury Department. I spoke to you on the phone.
Yes, I know.
This is my assistant, Ted Shills.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, come in, gentlemen, and sit down right over here. Make yourself at home.
Thank
you. There's nice, comfortable seats right here. Just sit down right over there. That's the idea. Well!
Now, Mr. Benny?
Yes.
Now, Now, Mr. Benny.
Yes, yes.
Now, Mr. Benny, we usually don't come out on Sunday, but Washington felt that this matter couldn't wait.
It couldn't? Look, fellas, why don't you give me a break? I mean, if I made a mistake, it was an honest one. Believe me, it was. I mean, I don't know anything about mathematics. I mean, I'm an artist. I'm a violinist.
Mr. Benny.
And look, supposing I did deduct $1,000 for medical expenses. I mean, a man my age usually is sick. and those rides I took to the bank, I mean, they were fun. You know, you could write that off as entertainment.
Mr. Benny, what are you talking about?
What?
I said, what are you talking about?
About my income tax.
We're not here to see you about your income tax.
You're not? But you said you were from the Treasury Department.
Well, that's right, Mr. Benny, but we're not in the income tax division. We're connected with Fort Knox.
Oh. With Fort Knox.
Well, you see, Mr. Benny, as you know, Fort Knox is where the government keeps all its gold.
Yeah.
And naturally, we're constantly striving to improve our methods of security.
Oh, naturally.
Well, to make a long story short, Mr. Benny, we've been sent here to ask your permission to see your vault.
My vault?
Yes, we'd like to see what methods of security you've developed.
I mean, that's why you're here? That's the only reason that you came here?
Certainly.
Oh.
Hey, boy! Where should I set this?
Take it back to the kitchen. We don't need it. So you gentlemen want to see my vault, huh?
Yes. And we were told that you have some very ingenious devices for protecting your money.
Well, I must say that I have, yes, and most of them are my own ideas. But if you'd like to see my vault, I'll be very happy to show it to you. Just follow me, gentlemen.
You go first right through that door right there. No, that's not the way. No. Follow me, gentlemen.
That's me, 20 years ago, just before I got into the Crest test. I'm Beverly Dahlsbeam. That Crest test changed my way of thinking about cavities and dental care. And my daughter Julie already uses Crest. We want her teeth to be terrific, too.
Beverly Dahlsbeam helped prove Crest fluoride works, and in test after test, in more ways than any other toothpaste, we're still proving it. Crest, 25 years of proof behind it, a future of good checkups with it.
I'm showing Carol how to save money with unsweetened Kool-Aid and sugar, just like my mom showed me. I remember how we mixed Kool-Aid. Mom said it was so inexpensive. I thought it was so delicious. It's still delicious. And today, with my sugar, it's only about 12 cents a quart. It has vitamin C, too.
When I'm a mommy, I'm going to make it for my kids.
Kool-Aid brand soft drink mix and your sugar. You loved it as a kid, you trust it as a mother.
Fellas, not so fast, you'll get the bend.
Hey,
these anymore. Just hang them up here.
Oh, thank you. Mr. Benny.
Yeah.
Do you mind if we rest for a moment?
No, not at all.
Sure.
Rest all you want. Oh, darn it. This thing is leaking again.
What's leaking? Your swimming pool?
No, it's that fountain on the corner of Wilshire and Santa Monica.
Have you made a note of all the things we've passed so far?
Yeah, I get everything.
Okay, Mr. Benny, let's proceed.
Okay, now we just go through here. Follow me. Hello, fellas. I want you to get everything right for them. Stay right behind. Put in there an automatic thing that if somebody comes down here, gets down who doesn't belong, you see, when they open this door, that bulb goes off, you see, and clicks the camera.
Gosh.
Yeah. So far, I've gotten pictures of two gophers and the Count of Monte Cristo.
Well, that's very clever. You mean just now you took our pictures?
Yes. If you'd like any, they're $3 a dozen.
But if you sell them to us, Mr. Benny, you'll have to pay tax on the money.
Oh, really?
No, I won't, Ed. I think we're below the 3-mile limit.
Well, shall we proceed, gentlemen? Again. An extra precaution that I've taken there.
Two alligators?
Yes, two alligators. I used to have three, but my sponsor's wife wanted a bag for Christmas.
Well, how are we going to get across?
Oh, don't worry about that. Had this moat build, you know, I was going to make it a toll bridge, and then I figured that was kind of silly. After all, it's only me. Just follow me, just across here. Down, Jeanette.
Now, Mr. Benny, since we're here to observe, I'd like to ask you a question.
Yes, what is it?
Well, now, look, suppose someone does find the entrance to your vault in the living room.
Mm-hmm.
He descends the stairs. Let's see now. He gets through the minefield, through the poison gas, under the flamethrower, and then through that door with the locks,
uh-huh.
Gets across the bridge and survives the alligators. Then what's to prevent him from getting in there and getting your money?
Does that answer your question?
Not only answered my question, it sharpened my pencil.
Mr. Benny,
yes.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
Look, suppose that this device that we've just seen missed the man.
Uh-huh.
And suppose I were that man.
Yeah.
Well, what's going to prevent me from proceeding on through the tunnel,
yeah.
Down to where you have your money, picking up all I want, yeah. Then continuing out the gate, down the stairs, then grabbing it.
That's a favorite plant of mine. I call him Irving.
Irving, let go. Irving, I said let go. Naughty thing, you. Well, now, gentlemen, I hope that you've gotten enough dope here about my vault to take back to the government.
Wait a minute, Mr. Benny. What? Is this all? Is this the end of it?
Well, no. Actually, there's one other room, you see, but I can't permit anybody else to come into that room, so you'll just... We'll just have to go back upstairs. Oh, wait a minute. While I'm here, I might as well get some money. I'm going to need it anyway. So would you mind waiting right here?
Not at all.
Okay. Just be careful. Don't play with the alligators or something. Fool and his money.
Oh, it's you, Mr. Benny.
Yes, yes, Ed. How are you? How have you been?
Well, not too well, Mr. Benny. Lately, the air in here hasn't been too good. It makes my eyes water and makes me cough.
Oh, well, that's probably the smog that's seeping in down here, you know?
Smog?
Yes. Yeah, smog. That's a condition they have up there in the air that it's caused from the exhaust of, you know, of automobiles, you see.
Automobiles?
Yeah, you see, Ed, we haven't got horses anymore, you know, or streetcar. We have automobiles. I'll explain that to you later. But anyway, the smog has gotten to be so serious, you know, the condition that they're thinking very, very, very seriously of taking it right to Washington, you know?
Well, I hope George does something about it.
Well, you see, George isn't with us anymore, but then that's something that I'll also... Now, I'm going into my vault to get some money because I'm going to take a girl to the movies tonight.
Girl?
Yes, a girl, you know, a member of the opposite sex, you know.
Sex?
I'll have to explain that. I'll have to explain that to you later. Now, I'm just going in to take out some money.
Okay. I'll take my ether.
No, you don't have to. Just sit down and just turn around.
He's beginning to trust me.
Forty-five to the right, back to 60, and over to 15, and back to 110. There.
It's the fallout that frightens me.
I just took $10. I figure I'll be back in about a week, you know. Well, so long, Ed.
Oh, Mr. Benny.
Yes?
You know, in all the years I've been working down here, I've never had a vacation.
Uh-huh.
Can I have 2 weeks off this summer?
2 weeks off? Why, where would you like to go?
Carlsbad Cavern.
I'll think about it and I'll let you know. Anyway, have a good time. And I'll be seeing you. Bye.
Gentlemen, let's go back upstairs, huh? That's right. Right over there, be careful. Well, goodbye, Jeanette. So long, Irving.
Jack will be back in just a moment, but first...
You want two more souls by tonight? I'll bet you a $10 bill that you can't get Greg or Paul to sing. It's our
day. Here at the Top is a devil of a show. Premiering Friday, August 5th at 8:30, 7:30 Central and Mountain.
It's not a Pringle.
Elaine Anders loves Pringles. Today we surprised her. We put ordinary potato chips in a Pringles can.
How does that taste? Greasy? Should look at my hand.
Try this one.
All right.
With Pringles, you don't get the greasy taste of ordinary chips. You get fresh fried potato taste that's simply delicious.
How does it taste? It's nothing like it.
You don't have to say that to make me feel good.
I'm not saying it to make you feel good. If I didn't like it, I would tell you.
Pringles. People know a good chip when they taste one.
Lather up with Ivory for a pure, natural clean.
Some guys don't mind a perfumey smell, but I like a naturally clean smell, like you get with Ivory.
There's nothing wrong with deodorants, but I don't want to wash my face with them. Ivory makes me look naturally clean.
I use a deodorant, so I don't want one in my soap. Ivory makes me feel naturally clean. I like that.
Ivory, simple, basic soap without a lot of extra ingredients.
Ivory for a pure, natural clean.
Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen. How'd you like my vault? Imagine many of you wondering why Ed has been staying down there in my vault so many, many years. Well, truthfully, he's very happy down there, and he is very grateful to me. You see, he thinks I'm hiding him from the redcoats. Anyway, good night, folks, and I'll be seeing you soon.
The Jack Benny Show. Sponsored by the soap without a lot of extra ingredients. There's a pure, natural kind of clean when you lather up with Ivory.
Flyer with a dangerous hobby gets his wings clipped by Hawkeye in tonight's comedy on MASH. Right now, stay tuned as Phyllis celebrates her 45th birthday with guest Mary Tyler Moore. Next.
This has been a J&M production, and this is Don Wilson saying good night.
What did he say?
He said it's a pleasure.
New comedy with the Betty White Show.
That's more than he said to me on our entire honeymoon. I see you still have your mustache. Or did you have anchovies for lunch?
Mmm. All right, where is she?
Where's who?
Your mother. I only get homemade waffles when your mother's coming or when you wrecked a car. The car.
Those aren't homemade. Those are Eggo waffles.
They aren't homemade?
They taste more like homemade than the other leading waffle.
Mmm, they sure do.
They give you more of that great homemade flavor.
Your mother's not coming?
No.
Good. And let go of my Eggo.
Eggo waffles. They taste more like homemade.
From Kellogg's.
A Brookline sex ring charges. Details at 11.
Charge of crabs, a fisherman.